कैमरा स्टार्ट।
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. ए वार्म वेलकम टू एवरीवन फॉर द वेबिनार ऑन मैट्रिक्स मेथड फॉर सिस्टम ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस. आई एम डॉक्टर वी गीता वानी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड कन्वीनर ऑफ टुडेस वेबिनार. आई होप एंड विश ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर सेफ इन दिस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन. My sincere thanks to our management for their excellent support provided to conduct this webinar. It's my pleasure to extend a warm welcome to our beloved principal, Dr. P. Ramesh Kumar sir, IKSE coordinator Dr. D. Jagadishan sir, head department of SNH Dr. H. Umameshwaran madam, resource person Professor ASV Ravikant, and to all participants. On this occasion, I request our principal sir to say a few words about this session.
Thank you, madam. Good morning to all of you. Before hosting our Institute of Technology Management Studies, I invite all the participants for this webinar on matrix method for system of differential equations. So perhaps in the engineering field, mathematics is very, very important. We cannot separate mathematics from engineering because this is the basic fundamental thing for all engineers who are with the branch. And differential equations also very, very important to solve complex problems in the engineering field. So I have to thank the organizers for choosing a good topic for this webinar. On behalf of the management, I once again invite Professor ASV Ravikant Garu, Professor in NIT Kurukshetra, for accepting this one. So I wish all the participants a happy stay in this one. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now I request our IKSE coordinator, Dr. D. Jagadishan sir, to say a few words about this webinar.
Good morning to one and all. This is Dr. Jagadishan, IKSE coordinator. First of all, I thank to our management, our principal sir, for supporting to organize this webinar. And also, I would like to thank our research person, Professor A.S.T. Ravikant, head of the Department of Mathematics, NIT, Kurukshetra, for accepting our request and giving their more valuable pitch here. And also, I thank to our convener, IQSE members, for coordinating organizing this type of webinars in our college. I hope we'll get more information from our chief guest. Okay, thanks to one and all.
Thank you, sir. Now I request our IQSE member, Dr. V. Vijay Kumar, sir, to introduce our resource person. Sir, please.
Yeah. Good morning, everyone. Good morning to our respected chief guest. I would like to convey my thanks to Dr. D. Jagadishan and Gita Vani ma'am for giving me this opportunity. Let me introduce about our today's chief guest. Dr. ASV Ravikant, he completed his PhD in research in the area of numerical analysis at NIT Warangal. Formerly it was named as REC, now it is NIT Warangal. So his research was guided by Professor Y.N. Reddy. So he completed his research during the year 2003 in numerical analysis. He worked at BIT Mistra, BIT Vellore. His area of major research includes numerical methods. His research singular boundary value problems, singular perturbated and differential equations. Currently, he is working on the area of numerical analysis on fractional partial differential equations. So he published over 50 SCA and the Scopus journals. very familiar journals like Journal of Applied Mathematics and Computational Physics Letters, Computational Mathematics Applications, etc. So these are all some of the standard journals like Science Citation Index Journal and Scopus Journal, other reputed index journals. He published over 50 journals. He conducted two GIAN programs, that is Global Initiative of Academic Network, which is being funded by MHRD. His citation count is over 1,000, and he has a very good H index of 12 and the ITIN index of 19. Some articles have more than 100 plus citations. He has guided three PhD scholars, currently is guiding another three scholars, and he has guided two M.Tech research works and three M.Phil research works, and he completed four R&D projects from National Board of Higher Mathematics, NBHM, DRDO. So these are from these organizations he completed four R&D funded projects. And then he has given several talks in various national and international conferences. He is a subcommittee member of Model Curriculum Development for Diploma Engineering Students of AICTE. And he was a BOS member of for Mathematics for 2 years at JNTU Hyderabad. So he as well as he acted as a coordinator for institute level NBA work at NAD. He was the professor in charge for examinations, as well as he was the professor in charge for academic and senate affairs, chairman of institute furniture procurement committee for 3 years, warden, served as a warden, center in charge for admissions, deputy center in charge for admissions for B.Tech, M.Tech, particularly Joint Seat Allocation Authority and Centralized Counseling, etc. during the year 2015, 16 and 17. So currently he is the head of the department for mathematics for a second time. So he is working at NIT Kurukshetra, and he is the coordinator of equity action plan and under TechUp 3 projects of the institution. So it is a very bigger resume. I tried to minimize it within a short amount of time, because its content is very important to each one of us. So with these few words, I welcome professor to share his thoughts. Welcome, sir.
Good morning, everyone. At the outset, my heartfelt thanks to the SITAMS Institute management, principal, and the coordinator of this program. My special thanks to Dr. Geeta Wani, who has taken huge pain to make this program. In fact, I'll just start with sharing my screen, and then in fact my rather I can say presentation or the talk, I would like to say my experience towards some of the content in differential equations. In fact, my today's talk, its title is Matrix Method for System of Differential Equations. As our earlier one of our I think principal, he pointed out that differential equations plays a vital role in our real life. We can't say mathematics is different and other things are different. If we really wants to study the nature, we need to see how the equations are related, how the quantities are related. So when we quantify them, we will get naturally the differential equations. Each and every object, it moves or it grows towards time. Pardon? Hello?
Sir, disturbance. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So, in my presentation, I would like to mention a few differential equations. Probably I'll pick two varieties of real-time applications on differential equations. And then I'll see a few basics of matrix theory. In fact, we teach all these things in our classroom, but in a different style. We teach matrix in one module. Later, we'll teach a differential equation in other module, and so on. We never see them integrated. Now, in this talk, I would like to integrate. I'll try my level best to integrate the simple mathematical processes which we regularly teach in our classes. So let me, of course, if we really wants to, for a simple, if I want to say a simple process, say we have a two-storied building. If we really wants to identify temperature inside the building, what kind of model or what kind of a mathematical representation we get it. It's a simple thing. Of course, every day we see it. When you go to our home, if it is a 2-4 or 3-4 building, in each floor, it has a different temperatures. How these temperatures are coming? What kind of model it is? What kind of mathematical structure it gives? Ultimately, it gives a simple system of differential equations. As we know, the simple law of Newton's law of cooling, because it's if the temperatures are small, the difference between a body and its surrounding, the rate of cooling of body is directly proportional to the temperature difference and the surface area exposed. This is the Newton's law of cooling. So let's use this same quantity. Now, my presentation here is, I'll just pick an introduction about two models, and then later I'll touch upon the eigenvalue and eigenvector. Of course, everyone, we know how to calculate eigenvalue, eigenvector. Still, let us recap the concept of eigenvalue and eigenvector, and then we'll see what is the meaning of eigenvalue problem. And then I'll touch upon how this matrix theory helps us to solve the differential equations. Of course, two few references in it. Yeah, my drawing was a little, hope it is visible. In fact, I just want to pick it in a sort of a square box. Later, I thought cylindrical gives more for the visualization. Hopefully, this cylindrical shape gives you better understanding. I just picked a fish tank. Hopefully, it is a transparent glass. Every day we see in our homes, we have aquariums. Of course, it is in a rectangle shape. I have taken here as a cylindrical shape. Here, this fish tank, what I did, I just picked some fiber plates. These are the three fiber plates. What I did, I have taken the same length of the fiber plates, and then I kept the fiber plates in this fish tank. I divided the whole fish tank into three different compartments. Now, what happens to the temperature on this problem? Let us suppose here y1, y2, y3. These are the temperatures in y1 gives the temperature in the first tank, y2 tells about the temperature in the second tank, y3 tells about the temperature in the third tank. Of course, I picked the same material, glass material is same, fiber material is same, and the volume of these tanks are also same. For simplicity, I have taken all these things. They are all same. Now, what we do, how they behave over the time. When time goes, what happens to these functions y1, y2, y3? Is from time goes, what happens to these? What are the temperatures in each and every tank? Of course, when you see this, this gives a simple differential equation. It looks like a diffusion equation. So let us see carefully one equation so that other two equations are more or less similar, and let's understand how we get at least one equation first. What determines the flow of this change in the temperature y1? It is conductivity across the two barriers y2 and y3, because heat can flow from y2 cell as well as y3 cell. So it means the temperature changing or the flow of change in the temperature in y1, which is equal to temperature difference between the tank 2 to tank 1 and plus temperature between tank 3 to tank 1. That's what the simple Newton's law of cooling. So dy1 divided by dt is equal to k times y2 minus y1, means it's a difference between body temperature and surrounding temperature. Surrounding temperatures for y1 is y2 as well as y1. So let's see what happens to the flow or the temperature difference between these two, y2 minus surrounding y1. It has two surroundings, y2 and y3. So y2 minus y1 plus multiplied with some constant. Similarly, from this y3, it is one more surrounding to the y1, for k plus k times y3 minus y1. Now this gives you the first order differential equation corresponding to the y1, in the flow of change in the temperature in y1. Similarly, or rather I can say, I can pick here minus k1, k into y1, here also minus k into y1. So I can write it minus 2k into y1 plus y2 plus y3. So y1 dash t is equal to minus 2k y1 plus y2 plus y3. So this gives us flow of change in temperature in first tank. In the similar way, you can calculate the differential equation with respect to y2 also. Similarly, differential equation with respect to even y3. So when you look into this system, it gives you first order system of differential equation that can be modeled or that can be represented in terms of y dash is equal to ay. Here a is a 3x3 matrix and their coefficients are minus 2k, 1, 1, minus 2, minus 2k, 1, 1, and 1, 1, minus 2k. So you can write this particular thing in terms of a system of first order differential equation. Of course, this we can see in our every day we see in our home. So if we are not caring about the temperatures, if we are leaving the fish, if we keep the fishes inside without take caring about the heat, after some time the inside these fishes in the tank 1 and tank 2, tank 3, they may die. So that's why we kept some sort of oxygen, we maintain the oxygen there. That's how we can see differential equations in first order system of differential equation in real time. Let me point out one more physical problem. I just picked two masses which has been attached with simple springs. Here y1 is the displacement at the first spring from its equilibrium position. Y2 is the displacement on the second mass from its equilibrium. Here K is the spring constant for this spring. Capital K is the spring constant of the middle spring. Small k is the spring constant of the third spring. Of course, for simplicity, I have taken masses are same. Now let us see what happens to the oscillation of this particular system. In fact, we have to work out with the Newton's law, and the another one is Hooke's law. First, we want to know what are the forces on this particular y1 when it moves from its equilibrium, where if y2 is fixed, that is force on one moving from one to one, that is minus k times y1 capital minus capital K y1, that gives the force on one from moving one. Here sign on both chosen so that they oppose the motion of the mass. There is also a force on y1 if it move y2 holding y1 fixed. Now that is force is simply minus k times y2. To check the signs, note that if y2 is increased, it pulls y1 to right. There is no contribution of this force from the spring between the second mass and the wall, since there are moving masses by hand and just asking how it affect the first mass. This is the differential equation for the first displacement, and this gives the displacement or differential equation for the second mass. So when we look into this particular system, this gives us a second order system of a differential equation. Oscillatory motion gives us a second order differential equation for us. Throughout my content, I'll pick these system of equations, these two system of equations, how beautifully, what kind of physics they are giving, and when we solve them mathematically, we give some variables, how these variables represent the physics of this problem. This I'll discuss in later slides. Now I just want to recap how to calculate eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a simple matrix. Let us pick a 2x2 matrix, 1, minus 1, minus 2, 0. How to calculate eigenvalue and eigenvector? It's a determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0. Let's identify determinant of A minus lambda I, which is equal to 0. So which gives us a quadratic equation in terms of lambda square minus lambda minus 2 is equal to 0. So here we get, it's a quadratic equation, so we expect two roots. Suppose we identify these two roots, we get two roots, lambda is equal to 2, lambda is equal to minus 1. These roots are known as eigenvalues of the matrix A. Now if I substitute lambda is equal to 2 in the system, AX is equal to 2 times, of course, 2. I need to get 2, okay. 2 times X. Here lambda I have substituted 2. X is a vector which contains x1 and x2. Now you can take these 2 times x into right hand side and solve them. We get x1 is equal to x2. It means you can calculate a vector. If we substitute x is equal to 1, xt is equal to 1. So we get a vector which is 1, 1. This vector is known as eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue 2. Similarly, we substitute lambda minus 1 in the Ax is equal to lambda x, and we can get one more vector, which is nothing but eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue minus one. Of course, this everybody knows it. And I just want to recap how to calculate the eigenvalue, eigenvector for a given matrix. In fact, my throughout presentation, I'll repeatedly say our eigenvalue is this and then eigenvector is this. So that's why I just want to recap how to calculate eigenvalue, eigenvector of a matrix. Now, I just picked a matrix A. I pick a vector X. Now let us see what happens if I multiply this vector with the vector A, a matrix A. If we multiply these two matrices, we get 3, 6. So you got a vector has been multiplied a matrix, square matrix A, which is given a vector for us, 3, 2, 3, 3 6. Is this? 1 minute. Now, geometrically, what this particular what happens to this vector? Suppose I have taken the picked the xy axis and then I mapped this particular point. So it's a simple line. It is a simple line. Red says about vector X. I think somebody is using the drawing. Hello. Is it audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Somebody is using these anatomy.
I stop, sir.
I will stop. Yeah, please, kindly. Yeah, now let's see. I think you can stop the this particular process for others so that it will not be disturbing. Somebody is using it. Somebody is using these anatomy pencil. Hopefully you can stop those people doing that anatomy. Please kindly stop it so that I can continue my presentation.
Okay, sir. I'll do, sir.
Participants, please don't do annotation.
It gives some irritation and we lose our concentration in the.
Yes, of course.
Yeah. Now let's see vector X. It has been plotted. Red thing is vector 1, 1, X. Now, what happens if it is multiplied the matrix A? So after multiplying vector X with the matrix A, this vector, it has been, you can observe it. It has been scaled, not only scaled, it has been rotated also. It means the moment you multiply a vector with a matrix, there is a scaling as well as a rotation. So you can't say this particular vector produces a beautiful thing. Now let us see one more case. I picked the same matrices 1, 2, 2, 4. This time I changed the vector 1, 2. I have taken a vector 1, 2. Now let's multiply these two things. Ax gives us 5 times 10. So now new vector is 5, 10. Now let's draw these two on the graph. What happens? Now you can see, the moment we draw vector 2, when it multiplies the matrix S, we got a new vector 5, 10. This vector X has been scaled You can see these AX, if you take a 5 as common factor here, a scalar quantity has been taken common, and we got 1, 2. Again, it means AX is equal to 5 times into X. So there is a vector which has been multiplied with a matrix, scalar multiplied with that vector. This gives us a more popular story and more popular problem for us. We can generalize it. We can see that it means here vector, a particular vector undergoes pure scaling without any rotation, is no corresponding to this matrix A. Similarly, the scaling factor is known as eigen value of this particular matrix A. It means we problem now. So geometrically, a vector multiplying with the matrix A, if it is producing us a scalar times matrix or scalar known as eigenvalue problem for us. Here, X is a solution vector for this system, and Cx is also a solution where C is any arbitrary constant for us. Let's see. Can we really see this eigenvalue? Because my interest is, of course, we teach these things in our classes. We solve several examples. Hopefully, we will miss the geometrical importance of these eigenvalue and eigenvector. Similarly, beauty of the eigenvalue and eigenvector. I just want to point out for that once again. I'll pick our previous problem, which is a coupled oscillator problem. I have given already how we land upon this system of differential equation. I just pick that particular equation, and I will rewrite this particular differential system into system of differential equations. Here, capital A is a square matrix, small k plus capital K, K, capital K minus small k plus capital K. Capital Y is a vector. Sorry, it is not X, it is Y. Capital Y is equal to Y1, Y2. So what we do, we just substitute capital Y is equal to a vector times e to the power of RT. So differentiate two times with respect to T. If you differentiate with respect to T with Y, dy by dt is equal to x times differentiation of e to the power of rt with respect to t, that gives r into e to the power of rt. Once again, if we differentiate with respect to this, then we get y double dash is equal to x times. Earlier we have r e to the power of rt. We'll differentiate with respect to t. It means r square e to the power of rt. So now we substitute this right hand side, we get m times r square into x. Left hand side, a times e to the power of rt into x. Both the time, both the sides we have e power rt, we can cancel them. So we get m r square x is equal to ax. Now we can see this particular thing. To rearrange it, let us assume r into r square into m as lambda, so that you can say this is an eigenvalue problem for us. Ax is equal to lambda x, where lambda is equal to m into r square. So system of differential equation, it can be represented into an eigenvalue problem by transforming y is equal to x times e to the power of rt. Now let us see how we will calculate once again eigenvalues and their corresponding eigenvectors. As I presented earlier, how to calculate eigenvalue and eigenvectors, one can easily exercise. If you exercise them, we get eigenvalues, two eigenvalues, minus k, minus small k plus 2k. And let's and we know that previous slide I have given you, lambda is nothing but m into r square. So revert back, so that you can get r square is equal to lambda by m. So it means we have two roots, R1 is equal to plus R minus square root of minus K divided by M, which can be a complex conjugate, plus R minus I into root K by M. Similarly, another root we can easily evaluate, plus R minus I square root of small k plus 2k by M. Now let's see what is the eigenvector corresponding to this particular thing, root k by M. Substitute it and get back to the eigenvector. We get eigenvector as 1, 1. Similarly, you can catch all the second eigenvector corresponding to the minus k, minus 2k, that we will land upon 1, minus 1. Now, let's see. Let's see the beauty of this particular thing. In fact, we have taken a physical model which says about a coupled oscillator. Here we have two eigenvalues and correspondingly we have eigenvectors. Will they say any physics or will they say any physical meaning? Because as we have taken a physical example, this is our physical example. So we got two different eigenvalues. What they represent, in fact? In fact, when we substitute R is equal to square root of lambda 1, it means plus R minus I. So one possible mode of vibration has angular frequency 1 unit. Corresponding to the mode of vibration, both masses are moving in the same direction. Both the masses moves in same direction, either in the left side or in the right side. If M1 moves 1 unit right side, M2 also moves 1 unit right side. Or if M2 moves 1 unit left, M1 also moves 1 unit left. Means our eigenvector says about that particular thing, because its a sign is 1, 1. Eigenvector is 1, 1. There is no sign difference here. Whereas when we see the second eigenvector, it has 1, minus 1. It means when we pick the second mode of vibration, it has angular frequency of k plus 2k by m. And corresponding to this mode of vibration, the masses are moving in the opposite direction. How I am saying masses are moving opposite direction? Because the eigenvector has sign, one of the vector is saying negative 1. Here you can see 1, minus 1. It means that both the masses are moving in different directions. If M1 moves 1 unit left side, M2 moves 1 unit right side. Means they travels or they moves opposite direction. At the outset, I can say these kind of vibration problems, eigenvalues tells us about oscillation frequencies of the system, and the corresponding eigenvectors tells of the relative displacement of the masses. Now we have another typical choice. Instead of picking, of course, for simplicity, I have taken both masses are same. If masses are different, if we are picking two different masses, then we'll have a generalized eigenvalue problem. Not eigenvalue problem. Eigenvalue problem is Ax is equal to lambda x. If we are taking masses are different with different masses string constants, you may get up with the generalized eigenvalue problem, which means Ax is equal to lambda times Bx. Both the sides you will have a square matrices. Now I'll just pick how we will utilize this eigenvalue problem and eigenvalues, eigenvectors, how they help us to solve the system of differential equations. I'll start with the first order system. Let's see how we will attack solution for the first order system with the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. In fact, we can process it in two different manners. One is direct method. If we know the diagonalization of a matrix, we can utilize even diagonalization process. So let me concentrate on two different approaches to handle a system of first order differential equations. Here I will explain, or I'll try to provide you the generalized process for attacking dy by dt is equal to ay with the help of eigenvalue problem, or rather eigenvalue and eigenvector. For simplicity, I just pick capital A is equal to 3x3 matrix. If I'm taking x is 3 by y is a is a 3x3 matrix. Now, as I pointed out in my previous slide, whenever you have a differential equation, system of differential equation, let us assume y is equal to x times vector times e to the power of lambda t. The moment you substitute this particular thing, you get an eigenvalue problem. As I pointed out, you substitute, find out the first derivative. It means y dash is equal to lambda times e power lambda t times x, which is nothing but a into e power lambda t into x. Both the sides you cancel e power lambda t. You can get rid of. So you get ax is equal to lambda x, an eigenvalue problem. X is containing x1, x2, x3. Now, once you know eigenvalue problem, you calculate eigenvalues, eigenvectors of the matrix A. Once if you calculate eigenvalues, eigenvectors of matrix A, solution for this 3x3 system, simply you can write C. You need, because it is a 3x3 system, you expect three linearly independent solutions. It's a superposition of all the three linearly independent solutions, C1, Y1, plus C2, Y2, plus C3, Y3. As we have assumed solution as e power lambda t x, let us substitute y1 x1, c1 e to the power of lambda 1 t x1, c2 e power lambda 2 xt, c3 e to the power of lambda t x3. This gives us here x1, x2, x3, they are the eigenvectors corresponding to the matrix A. Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, these are the eigenvalues for the matrix A. So you can easily identify the solution of the system of first order system of differential equations. Here C1, C2, C3 are arbitrary constants that can be thrown away if you know the initial conditions. Let's see how to calculate or how we will utilize diagonalization method, which is different than the earlier one. Why I'm saying diagonalization method? As we know, system of differential equations has been converted into an eigenvalue problem. Once you know the eigenvalue problem, eigenvalues and corresponding eigenvectors, if you frame the eigenvectors in a matrix format, which is known as a model matrix, if you can construct a model matrix from the eigenvectors of the matrix A, if the matrix P is diagonalizable, if matrix A is diagonalizable with the help of model matrix P, then in fact instead of kind of identifying normalized model matrix, let's identify the normalized model matrix. In fact, normalized model matrix, if you identify, inverse of normalized model matrix is equal to M transpose of the matrix. So calculations are going to be much more simpler than this particular thing. Now let's see how we will attack the solution for this particular system. Let's same thing. Y is equal to P times X. Here P is already we have identified a model matrix, which is diagonalizable to this matrix A. Instead of P, if you are taking a normalized model matrix, you assume Y is equal to M times X. Now substitute this in the given differential equation to get new diagonalized system. Let's see how we'll get diagonalized system. So d by dt of, I have substituted y is equal to p into x, either p or m. So it means right hand side I have px, left hand side I have a into px. Now p is a model matrix, x is a vector. Now you can take it p into dx by dt is equal to a into px. Now what we can do, we can pick this P into, if since it came from the model matrix, certainly it has an inverse. So pre-multiply with the inverse matrix on both the sides, dx by dt is nothing but P inverse A into P. If you are taking the normalized model matrix, m inverse a into m into x, you will get dx by dt is equal to m inverse a into m into x, you will get it. Since normalized model matrix, if you take m transpose is equal to m inverse, so this will be very easy. You need not to calculate inverse straight away. Transpose of the matrix is sufficient. So we know P inverse A into P is going to be a diagonal matrix for us. It means dx by dt is equal to simply capital D or x. It gives us d by dx is equal to diagonal matrix times into x. The beauty in this is here we have taken a coupled system. We started with a coupled system. The moment you are using the diagonalization method, it gives a system is going to be a decoupled. Let me use the pen so that hopefully you. The moment you see this, this gives x dash is equal to lambda 1 x1 x2 dash 1 minute. I should say x, this one is x1, this two is x2. Now I will use is equal to lambda times, once again I'll use the text. Let's draw. In fact, we picked a system where it is a. I'll write what kind of system we have taken. Suppose. For simplicity, we have taken a system of differential equations. Here, if you see these two are coupled, you can't solve first equation alone. It is not possible to get this is the first derivative to this. So now you see right hand side you have y dash y1 dash is equal to a times y1 plus y2 b times y2, and second equation is y2 dash is equal to c1 y1 plus d times y2. Now this is a coupled system of differential equation. First equation is not sufficient to solve or identify y1 solution, or second equation is not sufficient to, you can't solve, what I mean to say, you can't solve the one equation, you have to solve these two equations simultaneously. The moment you use the diagonalization method, see these two equations, x1 dash is equal to lambda 1 x1, x2 dash is equal to lambda 2 x2. What happens when we use the diagonalization method, your coupled system of differential equation, it has been decoupled. You can easily solve this particular decoupled system. Solution for the x first equation you can calculate separately. Solution for this second equation you can calculate separately. Whereas in the first case, it is not possible. You have to solve both the equations simultaneously. So diagonalization method is much more simpler than the direct method. Now let me go for next slide. Of course, we can revert back. As we know, once we know x1, x2, y is the solution, y can be easily identified by multiplying x1, x2 vector with the either matrix P or matrix M. So you can get the solution for the matrix Y. Oh,
I didn't I have to clean.
Again, oh, one minute. I should stop. Now again, I pick the coupled oscillators where we have seen our previous slide, where we got m into d square y1 by dt square is equal to minus k plus capital K y1 plus capital K into y2, y2 double m times y2 double dash is equal to capital K y1 plus minus of K plus capital K. Here I just picked the means I mean to say I just picked m is equal to 1, small k is equal to 1, big k is equal to 1. I picked, I have assigned the values for, means spring constant is 1 for all the springs, and masses are also same. So this coupled system, we can express it into a system of second order differential equation. This you can write it y double dash is equal to ay, where a is equal to minus 2, 1. 1 minus 2, capital Y is a vector Y1 and Y2, which is unknown to us. We will calculate. As I pointed out earlier, we can solve this in either a direct method or the diagonalization method. For let us see one simple case study on this. Let us see what happens, how we will apply the direct method, how we get the solution for it. As I know, it has been transformed into eigenvalue problem. Let's identify eigenvalues and eigenvectors for that. We can get eigenvalues are minus 3 and minus 1. For the minus 3 eigenvector, you will get minus 1, 1. For the eigenvector minus 1, eigenvalue minus 1, we get eigenvector 1, 1. Now, as I pointed out earlier, C1, capital X1, e to the power of lambda 1 plus C2 capital X1 e to the power of lambda minus lambda 1 into T plus C2 X2 e to the power of positive root T plus C4 X2 times e to the power of minus negative root into T. This gives you solution for the system of differential equation. For this system, direct method gives the solution in this way. Here C1, C2, C3, C4, they're all constant. They can be evaluated by choosing the different initial choices. Now let's see what happens if you are going for the diagonalization method. As I told you, instead of a model matrix, normalized model matrix you calculate. So I picked the normalized model matrix M for the matrix A. Now let's substitute Y is equal to MX in the equation so that we get d square by dt square is equal to mx, which is nothing but a into m times x. This once again you can take m times d square x by dt square is equal to a into x. You can pre-multiply on both the sides m inverse so that d square x by dt square is equal to m inverse a into m is equal to x. Here m into a into m you can write either, since it's a normalized model matrix, M inverse is equal to M transpose. So aramze you can calculate instead, you need not to calculate inverse. You can just transpose of matrix help us, and you can get M transpose A into M, use the diagonal matrix for us. So you get, you can see the system of differential equations. X1 double dash, X2 double dash is equal to minus 3, 0, 0, minus 1, X1, X2. Here, minus 3, minus 1, they are the eigenvalues corresponding to the matrix A. Now, you can see this system, X1 double dash is equal to minus 3, X1, X2 double dash is equal to minus X2. It means you started with a coupled system, started with a coupled system. It means we have to solve these two equations simultaneously. The moment you are using the diagonalization process, it has been decoupled the system of differential equations. Parallelly, you can solve these two equations. You can get the solutions for x1, x2 separately. One can easily, it is simply x1 double dash plus 3x1 is equal to 0. One can easily calculate its solution. Similarly, second equation, x2 double dash plus x2 is equal to 0. You can calculate its solution straight away. Once if you know x1 and x2, if you know the initial choice, initial conditions y0, x0 you can easily calculate m transpose into y0, x dash 0 you can multiply with m transpose into y dash 0. So you can identify x0 and x dash 0 values to eliminate these two arbitrary constants. Once if you eliminate these two constants, you can get the solution by substituting or by multiplying this x1, x2 with the normalized model matrix M to get back the solution for the system of differential equation. Now I'll pick one or two simple case studies or the cases for initial approximations. Here I just picked initial conditions are y10 is equal to 1, y20 is equal to negative 1. y1 dash 0 is equal to 0, y2 dash is equal to 0. As I pointed out with the direct method, its solution is containing c1 x1 e power lambda 1 positive root plus c2 x1 e to the power of negative root times t and so on. Now use these initial conditions here, substitute them. So you get a system of equations in terms of c1, c2, c3, c4. These are all arbitrary constants. You just solve this system. You can get the values of c1, c2, c3, c4 values. Once you know the arbitrary constant, you substitute them in this, you get the solution for the system of coupled equations together with these initial conditions. Here I have picked the initial conditions. y10 is 1, y20 is negative 1. I'll explain what happens physically with these choices. We'll see in the next slides with a beautiful simulation how the solution structure. Now I'll pick with the here after substituting it, simplified solution is cos root 3 minus cos root 3. Y1 is cos root 3, y2 is minus cos root 3. Can we get the same solution if we are using the diagonalization method? Let's see. As I pointed out, x1, x2, we have already calculated a solution there. You calculate directly the initial choices. X10 is equal to minus root 2, x20 is equal to 0, x1 dash 0 is equal to 0, x2 dash 0 is 0. Now x10 is 0, means substitute t is equal to 0 here. Find out the derivative and then substitute the t is equal to 0. You can get back c1, c2 values. Similarly, for the second equation, you differentiate with respect to t one time and use x1, x2, 0 is 0 and x2 dash 0 is equal to 0. You can get back the values for c3 and c4. Those values you can get it in this way. C1 is equal to root 2 minus root 2. C3 is equal to c2 is equal to c4 is 0. As we know, we can get x1t is equal to minus root 2 cos root 3 t, x2 is 0. Substitute it. M is a model matrix, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. You multiply with this vector, so you get this solution. Here, the beauty is we have not solved the coupled equation. Coupled equation has been decoupled and then solution is very cheap. I picked the another boundary condition, initial conditions. Here, initially, y10 is 1, y20 is 2 for y1 dash, y2 dash. I have taken zeros. In the same approach, you can evaluate and you can substitute these arbitrary, you can substitute these initial conditions in the solution. You get arbitrary constants and then you can get the solution. This solution is the solution with the help of direct method. Let's see diagonalization method. In the same way, you calculate solution with the help of diagonalization method. Its solution gives us. Now I have picked one more choice of initial choices. This time I have picked y1 is 1, y20 is equal to 1, y1-0 is equal to 0, y2-0 is equal to 0. For this, the same thing, you just goes on, apply the initial condition, the solution, and get the solution with either direct method or the diagonalization method. Now let's see the beauty of this, because this particular thing I picked from simple physical model where I have picked a coupled oscillatory system. Now let's plot it. Let's go for simulating this and use the simulink with the initial choices. Y1 is equal to 0, y2-0 is equal to 1, y1-0 is equal to 0, y2- for these initial conditions. If I'm using these initial conditions, let's see, solution is cos t, means y1 is equal to cos t, y2 is equal to cos t at this. Now let's see, let's plot it. What happens? See the coupled oscillator. As I point out, results are very exciting. You can see the results, they are very exciting. And you can see these masses vibrate harmonically at the first natural frequency. How I am saying it is vibrating and first natural frequency, at first natural frequency. I'll explain it. Both the masses in phase with each other. That's what we have seen from our mathematics. And this depicts in the mode of mode shapes by the fact that the elements V1 depict are equal. V1 is the first vector, 1 and 1. This means for the first eigenvalue is -3 and its corresponding eigenvector is -1 and 1. It means if and only a mode 1 associated with the eigenvector -1, 1 is excited, then masses moves together in a phase manner. Means both the masses, you can see both the masses moves in the same direction with the same phase. Inner mass has no effect at all. And you can see harmonicity. If you this particular graph shows about the superposition of y1 and y2. Superposition of y1 y2 is a beautiful harmonic wave. Means your mass spring, this coupled mass spring, is producing harmonic vibrant system. With this initial, so you remember, with the initial conditions, 1, minus 1. Y1, 0, I have taken 1. Y2, 0 is, I have taken 1. Of course, initial velocities, I have not taken initial velocities. I have taken initial velocities, 0 only. Now, let's see, we have taken three different conditions, initial conditions. I'll explain with the second set of initial conditions. Now, see the second set of initial conditions. If I pick Y1 is equal to, Y1, 0 is equal to 1, y2 0 is equal to -1. Y1 initial velocity is at both the displacement y1 y2. If I take 0, even this system vibrates harmonically at the second natural frequency. Why I'm saying it is going in the second natural? Let me explain with the mathematical justification. See, in this case, when we incorporated these initial conditions, which are multiplied with the vector V2. So only the mode was excited. You can see the arbitrary constraints there. C3, I think we got -√3, and rest all, C4 is equal to 0. It means that mode 2 is, so it's not unexcited by these initial conditions. According to this mode shape, the amplitudes of the oscillations, you can see the amplitude of the oscillations of the meshes should be equal in the magnitude, but they are in opposite direction. Because for the -√-3, you have eigenvector is -1, 1. They are in the opposite direction. Note that the frequencies of the oscillations is higher than those associated in the second mode, first mode. In the mode 2, if you see the mode 2, inner mass has no effect. So only outer springs, they are the matters. In the first mode, spring contributed so that the force of the masses is generally be higher for same displacement from the equilibrium position. Resulting, you can see
you have a greater oscillations and faster oscillations that can be observed from this superposition of the y1 by 2. That's the beauty of this. So you can clearly observe both the masses are working in of one unit. If right side is one unit comes right side, left is also coming one unit right side. They are doing in opposite direction. Now I have picked one more choice of initial conditions, that is y1 is equal to 1, y2 is equal to 2. Means I have taken both the displacement at positive side here, and initial velocity is 0. So it's not exciting, and you can easily observe these vibration response looks complicated. It is not harmonic. That you can see why I'm saying it is not harmonic. That can be observed from the superposition of the solutions. Here red line is first solution y1, blue line is the corresponding solution for the y2. I think my time is over. Is it? I crossed my limit. It is 12:10. Should I continue? I have 2-3 more slides. Should I continue or should I stop? I think it is better if it is 15 minutes or 1 hour talk. I'll stop it.
Continue, sir. You can take, sir.
Is it okay? Should I get another 5 minutes? Complete in another 5 minutes.
Okay, sir. Take, sir.
No problem, sir. Continue, sir.
Dr. Jagadish.
Yes, sir. You continue, sir.
Okay. Thank you for maybe another 5 minutes. I'll wind up. Yeah. Now, so far, let me consolidate my discussions. We started with a matrix. Square matrix, we have identified eigenvalues, eigenvectors of the matrix A, and we have seen eigenvalue problem and physical significance of eigenvalue problem, what eigenvalue says about and what eigenvalues says about us. And then we picked a simple oscillatory problem, and then we calculated with two different methodologies. One is direct method and other one is diagonalization method. In fact, diagonalization method is very simple. For the coupled equations, it has been decoupled, and decoupled system can be solved parallel. You can use the parallelized process. This is what so far I have explained. I picked for three different physical environments. Yeah, in fact, in my earlier process, I have not touched upon how to calculate solution for y dash is equal to ay. Instead of using direct method or the diagonalization method, if we are knowing the exponentially matrix, even this also help us. In fact, why I am saying, let me use once again pen. I think this is not convenient. Text I will write. I just picked y dash is equal to ky with the initial choice y zero is equal to a. It's very easy for us to say the solution for this differential equation is y naught times e to the power of k times t. This is the solution. In fact, this cap says about e to the power of kt. Rather, I can write in this. So when you have this first order differential equation, y dash is equal to ky with an initial condition, solution for this differential equation is y naught e to the power of minus k times t. This is what we have learned, we have seen in our first course. Now, can we implement this particular concept even for system of equations? It means if we have a system of differential equations, y dash k is equal to k into y. Here capital Y is a vector for us. It gives system of y1, y2, y3. and so on. Now, together with capital J, what could be its solution? Its solution could be, so we need a matrix. It means we have to identify exponential of matrix A. So let us see with this particular concept. So going for exponential solution, let me go to a few definitions for exponential matrix. Suppose e to the power of A, here A is a matrix, square matrix assume. As we know, e power x is equal to 1 plus x by 1 plus x square by 2 factorial and so on. Instead of x, you have a matrix A. So instead of 1, you have to take unit matrix plus A times A divided by 1 factorial plus A square divided by 2 factorial and so on. This you can write it sigma m is equal to 0 to infinity A power m in power matrix divided by m factorial. Now, here this series satisfies whatever properties you have seen e to the power of x. E power 0, you can say unit matrix. E to the power of minus a, you can write it e power a into inverse of that. Similarly, e power matrix a into e power matrix b, it may not be equal to e power a plus b. This you have to observe. Similarly, e to the power of at, that can be expressed in terms of, here you multiply t once again. So you get it t to the power of k, t to the power of m. So sigma k is equal to 0 to infinity 1 by k factorial t power k a power k. It's an infinite series. This converges for all choices of a and t. Similarly, let us see what happens. Derivative of this exponential matrix. Derivative of this exponential matrix is, usually we get e to the power of a into t. Derivative is a times e to the power of at. So the same thing you will get. Matrix a times e to the power of ta. This is what the derivative of e to the power of ta tells us. Whatever properties you have seen for the exponential function of lambda x, they are all remains. Even for the exponentially matrix t. Because this is very important in handling the system of differential equations. Now let us see how to evaluate the e to the power of a. As I point out, if you can identify a model matrix P, if it is a diagonalizable for the matrix A, means P inverse A into P is diagonal. Let's calculate A is equal to P easy. You take the P inverse and A. So A you can write P into D into P inverse. A square you calculate. It means A square means A into A. So A is nothing but PD into P inverse. So PD inverse P inverse, PD inverse P inverse. Simplification is P into D square means A square is equal to P D square P inverse. Here D is the diagonal matrix which comes from the eigenvalues. We have to remember it. Similarly, you go for power matrix of A means once again you can calculate power matrix of A is nothing but P times D power N into P inverse. Similarly, as I point out at e to the power of a is, I have already written a to the power of m. So instead of a to the power of n, pd n power d power n p inverse can be substituted here and simplify e power a, that can be expressed in terms of p times summation of d power m factorial into p inverse. Now e power a, simply you can write it p into e power d p inverse. This one has to remember it. Similarly, e to the power of ta, instead of e power d, e to the power of t into d, you can write it. This you need to keep it. Let us remember e power ta is nothing but p into e power t into d p inverse. Now let's see how to calculate e power d. Since d is a diagonal matrix where it contains eigenvalues, for simplicity, I have taken 2 by 2 matrix. So I two eigenvalues we have. Now let us see d square is nothing but lambda 1 square, 0, 0, lambda 2 square, and goes on. To calculate power matrix of d. So d power n is lambda 1 power n, 0, 0, lambda 2 power n. Now we need e to the power of d. So e to the power of d, you can write I plus d plus 1 by 2 factorial d square plus and so on 1 by n factor d power n. So now you can see first elements. You add all the first elements in the, so 1 plus lambda 1 plus lambda 2 lambda 1 square plus and so on. Second elements 0, 0, 0. So all elements you add it, they are 0. Similarly, second row first elements, all the second row first elements are zeros. But here 1 plus lambda 2 plus 1 by 2 factor lambda 2 square and so on. So you have two series. This series is 1 plus lambda 1 plus lambda 1 square by 2 factorial and so on. This particular series, it looks like e to the power of lambda 1. Similarly, this series, it looks like e to the power of lambda 2. It means e to the power of power matrix D is nothing but e to the power of lambda 1, 0, 0, e to the power of lambda 2. Here, lambda 1, lambda 2 are the eigenvalues for the matrix A. Similarly, you can calculate e to the power of TD, e to the power of T, lambda 1, 0, 0, e to the power of T, lambda 2. Now, let's pick a simple example. Should I get another 3 minutes? Hello?
Yeah, time, sir. Not a problem, sir. Thanks, sir.
I'll complete this example and then wind up.
Yeah, continue, sir. You won't take time, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
That's your turn, sir.
Let's pick an example A, 2 by 2, 4, 1, 3, 2 is a matrix. Let's see e to the, what happens e to the power of A and what is the value for e to the power of TAT. You can easily calculate eigenvalues for the matrix A. They are 1 and 5. Similarly, you can easily calculate eigenvectors. For the eigenvector, eigenvalue 1, 1 minus 3 is the eigenvector. For the eigenvalue 5, we have eigenvector 1, 1. So you construct a model matrix. This can be diagonalizable and A is diagonalizable through this P. So you can easily see it. It can be diagonalizable. So you get eigenvectors. It is verified. E power A, as I pointed out in my previous slide, e to the power of A is nothing but P e to the power of D P inverse. Similarly, P is nothing but 1 minus 3, 1, 1. E power D is nothing but e power first eigenvalue, 0, 0, e to the power of second eigenvalue. Here lambda 1 is 1, lambda 2 is 5. That's why e 0, 0, e power 5. P inverse, you can easily calculate P inverse. That is 1 by 4 times 1 minus 1, 3, 1. Here I have written. Now you have a combination of multiplication of three matrices. One can easily calculate multiplication. That particular multiplication is 1 by 4 times this matrix, you will get it. Similarly, let us find out e to the power of t into a. Instead of e, it contains t, means e power t plus 3 times e to the power of 5t. Here also, instead of only e, cos t you will get it. So you can easily calculate e power a, e power a t also. Now let us see one example. System of differential equations, first order system. How do you solve this particular? As I point out it, solution for this particular system, you can write it dy by dt is equal to ay. A is nothing but 4, 1, 3, 2. Same thing, 4, 1, 3, 2. Whatever example just right now I have taken, I picked the same one. Solution for this system, you can write it yt is equal to e power at into y0. Here y0 is nothing but initial condition at y1, y2. Of course, I have not specified it. One can pick any choice of initial condition. Suppose initial conditions I have taken d1, d2. Let's see solution y1, y2. Earlier, I just in my previous slide, I have given you e to the power of ta. E to the power of ta is this. Let's use that particular t power a, because e to the power of at already we have calculated, substituted. So you multiply this here. Y1 is equal to C1 e power t plus C2 e to the power of 5t. Y2 is minus C3 C1 e power t plus C2 e to the power of 5t. Here C1, C2, they are in terms of d1, d2. Whatever choice, initial choices, we will pick it d1, d2. Based on that, you get the solution of this system. This is another way of approach to solve the system of differential equations. Here the thing is, if you really identify exponential matrix of A, again, there also eigenvalues, eigenvectors. So what I want to convey, if you have a square matrix, eigenvalues, eigenvectors, they plays a vital role even in identifying solution for the system of differential equation. Not only system of differential equation, we get a differential equations in our real life. Everywhere we get these kind of differential equations. Every physical model can be modeled into a system of differential equations. They may be linear or non-linear. You can easily, once if you know how to solve the linear equations, non-linear equations easily can be attacked by linearizing them. You get system of linear equations, and then whatever approaches we have seen, all these approaches can be extended. Yeah, when I read the coupled system, I saw this particular paper, coupled spring equations, written by Tams and Gurham. It is written in 2003, International Journal of Mathematical Education, Science, Technology. This particular paper is motivated me to pick the oscillatory problem with the simulation, with the help of eigenvalues and the eigenvectors. These are the few books one can read. One can extend, or one can explore these books to gain more knowledge in the system of differential equations. Glynn James gives you a dynamical system approach. Greenberg, he gives more detailed expressions are there. You can see. At the outset, so far I was pointed out to calculate eigenvalue, eigenvector, and then how we will convert the differential equation into an eigenvalue problem, and then how to calculate the solution. I think I came out almost for the last slide. Thank you everyone, patiently listen my rather I can say not a presentation, I can say my views towards how we solve system of differential equation, how we integrate the eigenvalue problem and the eigenvalues, eigenvectors for the solution of differential systems. Let me thank each and everyone who presented in this session.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable input.
Thank you, Jagadishanji.
Excellent visualization of mass spring system. Really, it's very good. Any doubts?
Madam?
Sir?
Dear participant, do you have any queries? Please ask directly to start. One person raised it. Manisha, to unmute and ask your questions.
Can we use this method for higher order differential equations? That one, sir. From chart, we got this question. Ravikant, sir, please answer for this. We got one question from.
Madam, to ask the sir directly questions.
Sir?
To ask the question, madam, to start, what a question posted.
If you want to ask questions, you can unmute and you can ask. Otherwise, I just read out that one. Can you use this method for higher order differential equations? That's one question they ask.
Sir, one question, sir, from that absence. Sir?
Ravikant, sir, is my voice audible?
Sir, immediate, sir. Sir, unmute.
Okay. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Now it's okay.
Yes, now it is audible. One question is, can we use this method for higher order differential equations?
Yeah, you can do it. You can convert the higher order differential equation to a system of either first order equations or the second order equations. And then you can apply this particular process comfortably.
Any questions?
Any other questions?
If you want to ask questions, you can unmute and you can ask.
So dear participant, do you have any question? Please ask directly. Analyst question, Sadbhag.
Yeah, I have seen somebody is asked about can we apply this into PDEs? Yeah, why not? You can reduce the PDEs into ODEs and then you can apply it comfortably.
Any other questions?
Dear participant, any questions? Shall we conclude?
Shall we conclude, sir?
Yes, I think no questions.
Okay.
I'll check. Okay, all are good feedback only. No questions. Some students have free feedback.
They can ask through an email.
Madam, we conclude, madam.
Okay, sir. It's my great honor to propose the vote of thanks to all
loudly, madam.
In making this webinar successful, first of all, I would like to propose heartfelt thanks to our chief guest, Professor A.S.V. Ravikant, for gracing today's webinar. Thank you, sir, for your very interesting and thought-provoking address. And I would like to express profound gratitude to our principal, sir, Dr. P. Ramesh Kumar, for his presence in this webinar. And I would like to thank our IQAC coordinator, Dr. D. Jagadeesan, sir, for his continuous support and guidance. I also thank our IQAC coordinators. I'm happy to express gratitude to our SNH HOD, Dr. H. Uma Maheshwari, madam, and SNH faculty, each and every one of the MAS faculty, to their continuous support. My sincere thanks to all. Once again, I thank you all for their cordial cooperation. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Sir, one question, sir. Sir? Sir, your audio muted, sir.
Unmute yours, sir.
Okay.
One question, sir.
Yeah, please, kindly.
In chat box, sir. Can be visible, sir?
Yeah, you can consider the directly. Yes. Yeah, in fact, I have not counted the direction because I want to make it more simpler. If you consider direction, you can formulate the equations, no issue. Okay, fractional PDEs. You want to make one more lecture? Fractional PDEs is a recent tool. In fact, I think it will take long time. You can have an email. I can discuss it.
This question from YouTube, sir.
Oh, I see. Yeah, you can see fractional derivative and fractional differential equations. You just pick 1 minute. I'll try to wind up with a physical example. Probably they can look into that particular thing. You take a cup of water or any fluid in a jar, and then you take a syringe. You just pick some liquid. You can take color, red color or blue color, some color. You just inject that particular color in the fluid and see how rate it is dissipating in that particular. Means blue color is injected in a particular fluid. The fluid is white color for simplicity, and you can see how the blue color is expanding in this particular jar of water. This can be modeled like a diffuse equations. If you are going for a diffuse equations, if normal derivatives, you calculate the solution, there is no issue. If you are using the fractional derivative, you can get the all the dynamical properties in a nice manner in a shortest time interval. Suppose see what's the difference between normal derivative and fractional derivative. Fractional derivative is nothing d power half divided by dt to the power of t, half derivative, quarter derivative, third derivative, 3/4 derivative. Means these are the discrete derivatives for us. How to calculate them? There are several definitions. Popular one is Capito's sense. In recent days, we have a Tanganoff-Bellini definition where it is not having the non-singularity. Probably one can chat with me directly for their doubt.
Thank you, sir. I think there is no questions. We can find.
Yeah, you can. One more question I have seen. If the eigenvalues are not distinct, is it possible to find model matrix? If you can identify linearly independent eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalues, that can be done. Eigenvectors must be linearly independent. So you need to pick out linearly independent eigenvectors corresponding to those distant eigenvalues. Then you can construct the model matrix.
That's all, sir.
Okay.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
for your valuable time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you, ma'am.
Right.